Now let's learn addition of 3-digit numbers without regrouping. Addition of 3-digit numbers without regrouping. I have two numbers, 134 and 242. I have to add these two numbers. So I will write down these numbers in the columns. I will write 1s, 10s and 100 on the top. After that, I will put plus sign. I will start from 1s place. 4 plus 2. 4 in our mind and 2 fingers up. 4, 5 and 6. So 6 is my answer. After solving 1s place, we will come to 10's place. Now look at the numbers carefully. 3 plus 4. 4 is a big number. We will keep 4 in our mind and 3 fingers up. 4, 5, 6, 7. So I have written 7 here. Now, after solving 10's column, we will go to 100's. 1 plus 2. 2 is bigger number. So, what will be the next number? 3. So, my answer is 376. 376. So, whenever you have to do addition of 3-digit numbers, make sure that you always write 1s, 10s, 100 on the top. After writing the numbers in column, make sure you put plus sign. Now start solving the sum from 1s place, then come to 10s place, then come to 100s place. So I will write my answer like this. Thus, the sum of 134 and 242 is 376. So this is my sum, or we call it answer. Now let us take a look at few examples. First sum, 23 plus 15. I have written these two numbers in the column. I have written 1s and 10s on the top. I have put plus sign here. Now I will start solving the sum from 1's place. 3 plus 5. 5 in our mind and 3 fingers up. 5, 6, 7, 8. So my answer is 8. 2 plus 1. So my answer is 3. 38. Now let's come to 3-digit numbers. I have written these two numbers in the columns. Firstly, I will write 1s, 10s and 100s on the top. Then I will put plus sign. Now start solving the sum from 1s place. 6 in my mind and 3 fingers up. 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 is my answer. 4 in my mind and 2 fingers up. 5 and 6. So 6 is my answer. 7. 7 is a big number. So I will keep 7 in my mind and 1 finger up. So my answer is 8. 869. Now let us take a look at another example. Here the number is 60 plus 8. So I have written these two numbers in the columns. Make sure that you write this 8 at proper place. Why I have written this 8 here? Because it has place value of 1s. So I have written 8 under 1s place. Now let's start solving the sum. 8 plus 0. Whenever we add any number with 0, our answer is 8, that same number. So I have written 8 here. Here we don't have any number. So it means the number is 0 here. So 6 plus 0, my answer is 6. Whenever we add any number with 0, our answer is the same number. Now let us take a look at other example. I have written these two numbers in the column. Now I will start from 1's place. 1 plus 0. Our answer will be 1. 5 plus 1. Whenever we add 1 to any number, our answer is the number which comes after this number. So what comes after 5? Our answer is 6. So I have written 6 here. Here there is no number. So it's 0. 9 plus 0 is 9. So 961 is my answer. Let us take a look at other example. 59 plus 30. I have written these two numbers in the columns. I have written 1s and 10s. Now let's start from 1's place. 9 plus 0. My answer will be 9. 5 plus 3. 5 is the big number. So I will keep 5 in my mind and 3 fingers up. 5, 6, 7, 8. So my answer is 8. So my answer will be 89. Let us take a look at another example. My question is 555 plus 3. Please write this 3 very carefully. The place value of 3 is 1s. So I have written 3 under 1's place. Now let's start this sum. 5 plus 3 is 8. So I have written 8 here. There is no number here. It means it's 0. 5 plus 0. It's 5. Again, there is no number here. 5 plus 0, 5. So my answer is 558. I hope you have understood addition of 2-digit and 3-digit numbers. Okay, bye-bye.